A very good morning, friend. It is a new video from the channel 24/7, and in this video we are going to discuss about the important days of science. No matter the question asked in every exam, it doesn't matter it is a PhD exam or it is a PG entrance exam or it is a graduate entrance exam. The universities ask questions, CSIR, ICMR, JNU, every institute asks question about the important days of science. And the videos available on the YouTube is just about telling the tricks on the national days, on the world international days, but they are not worth of remembering that, because it is an easy way to arrange and data, not a big deal to remember these days. In this video we just take the 6 days of a month, and in the next upcoming videos we talk about the further 10 to 15 days and the most important days in between them. So let us start our video. So important days of science. As you taking that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, these are the dates. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and these are the months. And these are the days. So when you remember a date 1, so it can be 1st of July, 1st of August, 2 December. When you learn in a simple manner, you have to learn about 4 different things. But in this video, you are just learning a date 1, and then you are coming to the month and then the days. So let us start our video. So 1st of July is known as the Doctor's Day. Now in this section, all the things are related to the doctors, to the hospitals. That's why I put all these in a box, and all these are related to the date 1st of July, August, October and December. So 1st of July is known as the Doctor's Day. Now you can remember another days with taking as reference 1 July as in Doctor's Day. Now 1 August, the doctors tells the women's after the pregnancy for the breastfeeding. So 1 August is the breastfeeding day. It is a simple one. Now October, the child born can be have the lack of hemoglobin or lack of blood volume, so it can be a blood donation day, 1 October. You can also remember 2 O's are coming in this and 2 O's are coming in the blood. It is just a simple trick or technique you can remember. 2 O's are coming and 2 O's are coming is a blood donation day. In the next, when a baby taken birth, there are many several tests are performed. So HIV test is also performed. So it is a World AIDS Day, 1 December. It is a most important day asked in every exams. In my Viva, when I am in the graduation time, the question asked on the World AIDS Day to me. In the microbiology, I think, Viva, the question is asked about the 1 December World AIDS Day. You have to remember. So these are the 4 days related to 1 July, August, October and December. 1st of July, Doctor's Day. 1st of August, World's Breastfeeding Day. 1st of October, Blood Donation Day. 1st of December, World AIDS Day. It is a simple technique that you can remember 4 days in just 2 minutes, I think so. In the next, 2nd. Now, in this we are related to the land things. Mainly the lands and the herbs and the shrubs. So 2nd of February, World's Wetland Day. If the land is wet, then the vegetables, the fruits can be grown, or the seed is able to be grow further. So the 2nd of February is the Wetland Day. Now 2nd of October, also known as Mahatma Gandhi's Jayanti, we know that, you can remember from there, World Vegetarian Day. Mahatma Gandhi's is the reference that you can remember the World Vegetarian Day, or the from the wetland you can remember the vegetarians day, that the vegetarian eat shrubs, herbs, plants and etc thing, not the animals product mainly. So October you can remember the vegetarian day from the Mahatma Gandhi, or you can remember the wetland mean the herbs and shrubs. will grow on it and vegetarian will eat them. So in this way you can remember. 2nd of December, here is the 1st of December, here is the 2nd of December. National Pollution Prevention Day. In the soil, many fertilizer and insecticide, pesticide sprays are used, DDT are used further. So it is the National Pollution Prevention Day. You have to remember it is a national, not an international. So it is a National Pollution Prevention Day, December. So in this way you can remember the days on the 2nd of February, October and December. 1st December, 2nd and in the upcoming 3rd December is also there, that is also related to the environment and the pollution. So 2nd of February, World Wetland Day, 2nd of October, World Vegetarian Day and 2nd of December, National Pollution Prevention Day. It is also known as NPPD. In the short term you can remember it. Now let's come to the third date. 3rd of May, 3rd of October and 3rd of December. Mainly you have seen that in pattern, the October and December both remain as such in the upcoming, in the three sections, that the 1st of October, 1st of December, 2nd of October, 2nd of December and 3rd of October and 3rd of December. Now here you leave the 2nd of December with the National Pollution Prevention Day. In the May it is a World Asthma Day. So if we do not prevent our environment or protect ourselves with the polluted air, there is an asthma or lung cancer can be there. So it is a World Asthma Day, Asthmatic Day it is also known as. It is the 3rd of May, World Asthmatic Day. In the May, June and August, mainly the asthmatic patient suffers more. So in the May it comes World Asthmatic Day. And now 3rd of October, it's World Animal Welfare Day. You can remember this from the October. In this we are the World Vegetarian Day and World Animal Welfare Day. Vegetarians are always in the side of the World's Animal Welfare Day because they don't eat flesh or any other thing. Now come to the 3rd of December, it is a World Conservation Day. You can remember it from there also. National Pollution Prevention Day, the World Conservation Day. You are maintaining the biodiversity, plants, animals, anything, flora, fauna is also coming to the World Conservation Day. So these are the third. You can relate first with the second and second with the third. If you watch this video two or three times, you can easily remember the main days from that the question are going to be asked. Now 4 October, here is the 3rd October, here is the 4th October. You can relate with this World Conservation Day, World Habitat Day. It is an easy one, 3rd to 4th, World Conservation Day and World Habitat Day. Now come to the next, 5 June, 4th October, 5 June, World Environment Day. These 3 or 4 can be linked in an extraordinary fashion, that World Conservation Day, World Habitat Day, World Environment Day. So it is in simple manner that if you are remembering one thing, wetland, then vegetarians, then pollution, then asthma, then animal conservation, habitat and environment. So these are in a chain form you can remember, and the months are also October, December, October, December, October, December, October, then June and August. Now come to the 6th August, that is the Hiroshima Day. You're listening your 5th, 6th or 7th classes about the Hiroshima and Nagasaki. 6th August is the Hiroshima Day, where is the 9th August the nuclear attack on the Nagasaki, that is 9th of August. I am not telling there. In the upcoming video I will tell about the Nagasaki another. So 6th August is known as the Hiroshima Day. So it is all about the important day of science. One question is every time asked in the CSIR examination, and 1 to 2 question in the PG entrance examination, always ask questions that are from the important days of the science, and other than this, these are going to help you in the in your practical viva voice or the theoretical viva voice. I hope you like the video, and please stay continuing for the upcoming videos and the next day of the month. Thank you so much.